Hello, my friends. My name is Ali Casper. Today, I will answer the questions of a few of the viewers. They were asking something like, how can you paint something that small? Okay, the one they're questioning is the 5x7. This is Chinese junk. Those people who've been to Hong Kong or Singapore, they have something like this, but I did it artistically. Okay, it's a simple one. It's a Chinese junk. It's like a little boat. Okay, so now I'm gonna show you that I can paint something like half of this size, or maybe 2x2. Could be 2x2. Okay, I'll show you 5 paintings. So please look at my video so you can learn a little bit of how to paint something that small. Okay, 2x2. So something like square, like this square. Okay, so please give me a thumbs up and subscribe if you're not in my group yet, if you're not with friends abroad in YouTube. So please subscribe so you can see some of my short videos. Okay, I'll see you in a little bit. So I can use this, and then this one for the trees, and what else, maybe a tiny one. Sometimes I'll just pick up something, whatever I like, maybe this one. So I'm gonna use 3 brushes today. Okay, so I already put the white paint, and next what I do is I'm gonna get some green. I'll wash this first. Okay. And I get some green. And now I can just put in it. And maybe this one is better. A little bit of yellow. Put some trees and bushes here and there. Okay. And then more green. Some bushes here, and then a little bit of blue for the bottom part. Maybe there's some lake in this here. Then maybe there's some trees far. Gonna put some twigs. Here is another one, my friend. It's too tiny, but it's a little bit detailed too, right? So give me a thumbs up if you like this painting. I mean, everybody can do what I did, okay? So I hope you like it. Give me a like and comment if you like it. It's a little bit small, but I'm just showing that we can paint anything small, okay? I'll show you my next painting. And then the birds, you just put something that match a little bit with the flowers. So it will just, it blends with the flowers. Or you can just put black, but to me, I'll put something that blends the flowers a little bit. So put a little black here and there, yellow there, you know. Something like that. So over here a little bit yellow, or you can just do whatever you like. And then there's another flower far distance that's very light. Can just put something light up here, maybe a little bit of twigs here and there. Twigs like far distance, so it's very light, tiny twigs over here. See, you can hardly see because it's far, it's like almost like foggy. There.
good. Put the little tiny twigs here. Something like that. And you can do whatever you like, whatever color you like. And if you don't like it, you can just erase it. Okay? What do you think, my friend? That's another one for today. Do you notice that I love flowers, I love birds, we live in a country where there are lots of birds, we have bluebirds sometimes that come visit, we have brown birds, I don't know them, but I don't know the names of the birds, but and sometimes somebody can visit us, bluebirds or, you know, something like that. I have some little bit of orange. Something like that. Just blend a little bit here and there. Something like that. And you can make some little twigs here and there. Then you can put a little bit of brown. And if you make a mistake, you can just cover it with something. So there's no perfect, you have your ideas in painting. So if you make a mistake, just erase it. And put another color. So there's no harm in painting, you can just cover it up if you don't like it. You know, some summertime, maybe you have, you can put a little bit of house here in the corner, you know, just like a shadow building. Don't have to be very detailed. You know, some like you put little orange, so it's like far distance and there's a shadow of a light. Very light, you know. Maybe put a little bit detail over here, a shadow of. And you put some orange in there. Orange is your light. And then there's a light there. There's a little window here. And I put a little twigs far distance. Tree that you can hardly see there. You can do whatever you like. See, there's a little tree behind the house. See, you don't have to be very see, it's like an evergreen tree maybe behind that house. Summertime, some a lot of grass like becomes brown because it's summertime. Some of the trees were like, I mean, the leaves kind of like brown now because summertime. So maybe a little detail on the house. You know, just like far distance. Can you see the house? It's difficult to draw details because it's small. It's just like an indent, just like something that look like a house in a far distance. Here's the building here, you know, gonna put too much because not much space, right? So put whatever you like, whatever color you like. There. Like, what is that in the far distance there? Well, it looks like a small building. There. And if it is too dark, you just have to lighten it a little bit, right? Okay, my friends, that's about it for today. Please give me a thumbs up and see if you like my arts. And I'll show you next time. What do you think, my friend? We'll see you next time. And please give me a thumbs up. If you're not subscribed yet, please subscribe. I will appreciate it very much. Thank you. Have a good afternoon. Bye.